Okay. Recording starts in 3, 2, 1. Hey guys, it's me, Malnex, and bring us some more Pokemon Uranium. In the last part, we made it here to Snowbank Town. Today, we are going to take on the gym. And, yeah, it's been a while since I last recorded this game. I think about 2 weeks now. So, let's have a small look at the team and where we are at. We have Arkele, the 47, Fire Ground type, Shell Bell item, that's nice, S51A, Blubberog, Delmafrost, Jelin, and of course Garlicid. Garlicid was one of those Pokemon that I was honestly thinking about taking out of the team and replacing him with something else. I think last I brought him around because he was a very high level Pokemon, but I feel like maybe I don't necessarily need him. Maybe, I don't know. But we don't have Fly yet, so I guess we can keep going with it. Anyway, Showing Wisdom. Your ability to adapt to different conditions. Your Pokemon's faith in your and your faith in your Pokemon and the strength to discern truth from lies. If ye fail any one of the tests, you'll have to start from square one again. Boy, let me tell you, it ain't easy to get up when you're knocked down, but keep on trying. That's what it takes to win. Because only when you pass the trials and defeat the leader Verin can you unlock the true power in your Pokemon, the power of Mega Evolution. How would an old man like you know all this? Well, to tell you the truth, I used to be an acolyte of the dragon myself. Now that winter cold on the mountain causes the old bones to ache, and stiff breeds could snap me in half, so I stay here by the fire giving advice to trainers. As thanks for your listening, I want you to have this. And we get the Drilgonite. This I believe allows Drilgon to mega evolve. I don't have a Drilgon on my team, so yeah. Anyway, let's keep moving. Have a look here. Bruh, I'm so cold. Say, do you have any Pokemon that knows overheat? That would be definitely one place. No, I do not. She will give you a Dawnstone if you have a Pokemon that learns overheat. So that could be useful for evolving. I don't know why it evolves. I know it evolves Curly into Gallade, a male Curly into Gallade, but I don't know any other Pokemon that evolve using that stone. We get some rare candies. Wow, that's very nice of you. Rare candies are, of course, rare, as the name suggests. So to give him away for free is not easy. Like, rare candies are something that not a lot of people you can't really find in the wild, because yeah, we don't even have a Repel. We're in a town, so there's no Pokemon. Okay. What should do? Pokemon centers will patch up scratches, burns, and the like, but tooth cavities require an expert. That's all she says. Okay, whatever. Okay, this is the Pokemon. We don't really need to go there yet. I believe this is where we came from. Yeah, this is where we came from already, so. That's pretty much it. What's over here? Well, nothing really. Just a bunch of ice. Anyway, oh yeah, might as well show this off in the Pokemon. Wait, hold on. No, yeah, she does give you the ability to. Does she? Why is she not giving you? I don't know. Anyway, she can give you, if you pay $500, she can give you. She can allow your Pokemon to learn one of the Fang moves, so Fire Fang, Ice Fang, Thunder Fang, Poison Fang, Crunch, and Super Fang. So yeah, that's something. I don't know why she's not allowing me to do that. We're done. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Nothing really else we can do. So let's just make our way to the gym, shall we? First off, I want to have a look at if we have the items that we need. We have a lot of hyper potions, 12 in fact. I think it will be good. So yeah, let's make our way up to the gym. I'm guessing this is the way. Yeah, it is the gym. Hey! It's Theo. Are you trying the gym? I guess I made it first. Haha! Surprise, I look different. I got some new clothes from Superfoot. That t-shirt wasn't working in the cold weather. Plus, now I look more badass. Anyway, I hear this gym is supposed to be really tough. Apparently, the trials you gotta face, but if you beat them, you get the power of Mega Visions. Cool, huh? Though, apparently, the gym leader's no pushover either. Ah, you two. You want to challenge the gym, no? Very good. This gym challenge is customary undertaking in pairs. What? Did you hear that? We get to tackle this gym together, me and Axion. Oh, well, not exactly. You will be split up for the trials, but reunite in time to take on the leader. Sounds good to me. What do you think? Okay, let's go. I healed up. Ready. Okay, so this is going to be interesting. In order to challenge the gym leader, Baron. You will need to complete 5 trials. Once you begin these trials, you must complete them without stopping. If you choose to leave or fail a trial, you must begin the test over from the beginning. I should also add, you will need a Pokemon that knows strength for the first trial. Do I have a Pokemon that knows strength? I don't know. Let's do this. Hold on. I don't think I have a Pokemon that knows strength. Let me just have a look. I think Dermafrost knows strength. Yeah, it does. So we'll be good. Okay, so let's make our way through here. Well, this is your first trial, the trial of strength. Show that you have the power to bend the world to your will. Alright, so I guess we gotta use strength to move the boulders around here. Let's activate it. Okay, so this should be relatively easy, I guess. Okay, so we can't. I may have done this horribly wrong, possibly. I don't know. You can't move 2 rocks at the same time. Can we reset it? Would you like to reset, please? Reset it. Okay, how are we gonna do this? Okay, so go this way. Did it. Alright. Okay. That was easy when I thought about it. Very good. You surpassed the first part of the trial. Now, see if you can overcome my might in battle. Okay. So, it's battle time. We're going up against the Acolyte Trofgar. He's got a Barrand, which is Dragon Ground. Alright, so Ice type. So, one walking Ice type. Move to the face. So, Dermafrost. Coming in and doing the business. I'm just gonna have a look at what this gym has exactly. Oh, bloody hell. The guy's not telling me. No, it is in the right place. Wow. I was just looking at the guide that I have, and it was. And, just wondering if it was on the right places. But it was. Anyway. What was that? I forget what that move is. Is that? I don't know what that move is. It was a move? I missed it. Oh, it doesn't matter anyway. It's gonna die one hit. Bye. Damn, Frost doing the business. Oh, I gotta get rid of the experience share. Fafur. Oh, this is the fire and. No, not the fire and. Is that, ice type. I know it's an ice type. Okay. Oh shoot, this thing is ice and something. Ice and ground? Ice and rock? Or something like that. Something along those lines, I don't know. But flamethrower won't kill it. Ice and rock, maybe. That's what it's typing. Maybe it's. I don't know. I don't know if rock types resist. Try that move. That's one thing. Alright, shoot 6. Okay, so I skipped on out on that because it's pretty easy. I found out that Fafur, I think that's how you say it, is actually a dragon and ice type, so it's weak to rock type moves and steel type moves, which is interesting. And fairy types. I feel like fairy types are going to be a lot more useful. Anyway, this gym is interesting because it's made up of both dragon and ice type Pokemon, so. Yeah, that's super interesting when I think about it, because ice and dragon are usually opposites. You know, ice beats dragon, and dragon types don't like ice, don't like the cold, because I believe they're cold-blooded Pokemon. Okay, so this is wisdom, so I'm guessing this is a massive ass maze. Okay, so I just basically gotta go backwards in my head. Go up, then nothing up again. Ooh, that was easy. Wow, all these tiles on me. No sweat. Very well. I see you have your mind. Wait, I see you have used your mind to think critically and navigate this room. Now, prove your wisdom by successfully countering my strategies. Okay, next up is Vansker, and he has a Frosulo. I'm guessing that. Wow. I can't really look at what these Pokemon are without pausing the game accidentally. So I'm gonna guess that it's it's a ice type. Maybe just pure ice. Maybe ice and rock. I'll find out later. Anyway. What's next? I think this thing is a dragon type. Coralith. So Dermafrost gonna do the business. I keep forgetting to take off the experience share from S51A, which is going to screw me, I think. Anyway, Avalanche. We'll always go second, because I believe Avalanche, oh god, was super effective. But we lived it. Doesn't matter. I think Avalanche has it always goes second. It has lower priority than every other move. So yeah. I think this thing is grass and dragon. Yeah, it must be. Because it took a lot of damage from that. Voltasu. This thing, I believe, is ground and electric. No, electric and dragon. I think. Maybe. I don't know. No, it's flying type, isn't it? It's a flying type. Then it evolves into a dragon type. But it doesn't matter if I went for Rock Slide or if I went for Avalanche. I went for Rock Slide this time. Oh, it flinched, so we can be able to finish it with the Ice Shard. Having Ice Shard is very useful because it is a priority move. You'll see it used in a competitive battle a lot, because Ice type Pokemon in general are not very fast. So to have a very good, Mamoswine uses it very well. It's a very good, it's void based power, so it's not very powerful, but it is priority, and priority always helps. You know, that's why a lot of people sometimes run quick attack on certain Pokemon, as well as I believe they can also learn. I gotta give something. What am I gonna give them? Life Orb? Nah, bad idea. Go for. You get an expert belt. Why not? And we'll take Demofrost to the middle, and then we'll heal him up. Okay, that's done. Let's make our way through. Ooh, what the hell we are? This trial will test your ability to adapt to rapid change. For a good trainer, the elements should pose no threat to the way to perfection. Oh, there's Theo. Okay, so this is one of those puzzles. The slidey puzzles. And it sounds like it's howling. Do we need surf? Yeah, we need surf. Why didn't they tell us we need to surf as well? That doesn't make any sense. Whatever. I must have missed it then. I wasn't paying attention, but that was relatively easy. You've shown that the forces of Mother Nature are not enough to stop you. Defeat me to prove that this adaptability extends to your battle style as well. Okay, Zai, what you got? Oh no! It's the monster! It's Tunseraph! Oh, what we'll do? Oh yeah, we have a nice time. Thank God for that. Avalanche! Don't flinch, please. Don't flinch. Anyway, flying dragon type, 4 times we... Of course it fucking flinches, because why wouldn't it? Why wouldn't it flinch? Anyway, 4 times weak to... Flying... 4 times weak to ice type moves. This is gonna kill it in one hit, probably. I think so. It should. Come on. Yeah, it did. Flying and, dragon. That's a combination that fears ice types. Traction is next, so yeah, we should go Archelaus here. Perfect Pokemon. No, we'll hit him up with the flamethrower. Okay. What's next? Flamethrower. When are you gonna learn Earthquake, man? I'm sick of Magnitude, because Magnitude, man, you never know when he's gonna kill one of your opponents. It's one of those moves, Dragon Rush, and it missed. But it's gonna get faster on the second turn, which is horrible. But hopefully, we'll be able to finish it. Yeah, we do. Oh, does it not have speed boost as an ability? I'm guessing it doesn't. Okay. Must have a secondary ability then. Level 48. I've been looking at the gym, it's around level 50 something, so we are actually low level for this next gym, but we should be okay, I think. Man, Garlic Kid, you are in the worst shape to be taken on. Actually, you might be okay if you hit hard enough. So, in comes Garlic Kid. Hopefully you'll be able to do some sort of damage to her. Drain, I think he has Drain Punch, Giga Drain, Mach Punch, and Mach Seed. So this is a Pokemon that loves to live. Loves to steal from his opponents. Super effective move. Hopefully he doesn't hit me with like killing one hit. Nope, of course not. Ice Beam. Oh sure. This is my choice. Cause I think fighting types don't resist. Yeah, fighting types don't resist ice type moves, even though they're strong against ice types. So this should do it. Okay. It's the end of Zai. Well done. Man. I'm a little bit sorry for using... I feel like I should have used Barshawn's evolution. I heard that's a really good Pokemon in this game. It's dark and fighting. I feel like I should use that Pokemon. I'll think about it. In between parts. Because I don't think Garlic is that good. We'll heal up for the next area. There's one more battle we can do. One more test, I think. No, there's actually two more tests. I'm wrong. A good trainer has faith in themselves and in the Pokemon. Even in times of fear, trust in your abilities and move onwards, the path will reveal itself to you. So, this is similar to the, I believe, that one from that one city, the Steel-type gym leader. Yeah, it was similar to that. So you basically have to go across 1, 2, 3, up, 1, 2, 3, 4, then up 3 times, then across, then up again. Okay, so that's relatively easy. This one is a lot difficult because it's actually much bigger. Because I have the guy next to me, it's not that hard. Up, up, up. Then left, left, right, right, sorry. Then down, then left, right, twice, then up 4 times? 3 times. 3, then across, 2, I'm not even moving. Oh, I fucked up. Oh, do you have stuff in the beginning? I did it! Okay, so that was something, I guess. My god, like, wow. I didn't think it would be that difficult, but I did it. It was, oh my god. Okay, I'm not doing that again. Anyway, are I said weak to rock types? Yes, they are. Okay, so we should be good. Okay, let's go. Excellent work. You have shown that you have faith in your abilities, but do you have faith in your Pokemon? Okay, let's see what this guy's got. He's got a Glaceon. That's okay. Yeah. So I kind of predicted that. I kind of predicted he would have some sort of... I think Dumfrost will do a lot of damage here. Do a lot in terms of... Last Resort. Okay, Last Resort is basically an attack after you've used all your other attacks. Ooh, another Dumfrost. Dumfrost and Dumfrost action. This one's higher level. It's like six levels higher. We're not gonna be able to take this thing out in one hit. So what we're gonna do? It's probably gonna go for Rock Slide or something like that. We're going to Garlicid. Yeah, we're going to Garlicid. He'll go for Rock Slide, so we'll be okay. Stone Age. Oh, he's Stone Age. Okay, Stone Age is okay. We're gonna hit this thing with Drain Punch, get all our HP back. 4 times boost to fighting type moves. We should kill it. Even with Dumfrost has really good defenses and really good attack. It's just really, really slow. It's the biggest example of what a tank Pokemon is. Really, really bulky, but it doesn't really have that much speed. Glaceon's coming back out, so we're gonna give all the experience to Dumfrost. I don't want sharing experience. I don't want to share experience, I should say. I do like sharing experience. But right now, I want my Pokemon to be as high level as possible for the next gym. And I do not want to... You know, I don't want to be under level, that's for sure. Because, Pokemon in general, it's not just a typing game. Like, it's not just knowing what types go together. It's about also... What the hell is this Pokemon? Terabit. I think that is how you say it. Whatever this Pokemon is dying. Ooh, it has Earthquake! What the hell is this Pokemon? Dumfrost, please live. Oh, wow. We live a decent amount of health there. Okay, so... is ground type, obviously, but what else is it? What else it is? What else is it? I can't speak English, for God's sake. Anyway, looks maybe normal ground? Maybe that's his type ring? Because most rabbit Pokemon just seem to be kind of weak in general, like Lopunny. You have Diggersby though, but you have Lopunny. I think Diggersby is normal ground, so I'm guessing maybe it has the same typing? Possibly. Who knows? Anyway, let's heal up first. I've 8 high potions left. That's okay. Okay, whatever. I thought Darrenfrost needed a bit more help. I guess he didn't. Anyway, we're outside. This is the Axion. We just gotta go straight forward. We complete trial. Come on, let's go. Okay, sorry about that. When you click off the window, why don't like when you click off the window, why am I still walking? I should be running. I don't know why I'm walking. Whatever. Doesn't matter. Makes it feel more epic. This is the last trial, I guess. This is a straight up battle. You are pushed forward, undertaking many arduous attacks, and finally arrived at the truth. This will be your final trial. You are not allowed to use any items when we battle. Simply put your trust in your Pokemon's ability and move forward without any hesitation. That's fine. I don't really need any items to beat me. Antarctica. What the frick is this? I don't even want to know. It's insane looking. Whatever. It's not ice. Is it ice type? Ghost type. There's no shadow thing. It must be a ghost type then. Or maybe it's safe. Whatever it is, it's dying. That's the important part. Shadow Ball again. It must be a ghost type. It's not that much damage from Shadow Ball. It must be a ghost type. Is it ghost and fire? Maybe. I don't know. I have to find that out later on. Next is Dunseraph. I can't use any items. Okay, whatever. We'll go for Ice Shard. Hopefully we'll be able to kill it in one hit. Because I don't think... If I get flinched by Air Slash, I'm screwed. So, Ice Shard. Oh, for frick's sake, critical hit and it didn't kill. Dragon Pulse. Oh, that just adds to my wounds. All my wounds. And of course, he gets a critical hit when I get a critical hit. And now, Darrenfrost is down. He's going to take damage from the hail. We're going to roll with my man. Okay, we'll be okay. Archeles will go. We'll go with Archeles. Because I think he has extreme speed, so we'll use that. Finish this thing off. Okay. Dunseraph. Next Pokemon, please. Pajay, I think it's fire and flying? I think so. Because I do believe it evolves into a fire and dragon type. I do think so, but anyway, we're gonna kill it with the surf. Or maybe it's not, yeah, I think it's one of those Pokemon that has two evolutions instead of just one. I do think it evolves into a dragon type though. Or maybe it is a dragon type. I don't know. Anyway. The gym leader is next. I can't believe it. We did it. Actually, only completed all 5 trials. Mega Evolution is just one step away. The portal will allow you to travel to the start of the gym. If your trials are exhausted, you are welcome to take the great full challenge in the gym leader. I advise you bring Pokemon that is capable of Mega Evolution to the battle, that is all. Whatever you choose, let me know when you want to move on. Okay, I'm going to go to the Pokemon Center. I'm going to go to Pokemon Center, and then we'll make our way to the gym. Alright guys, back in the gym. It's time to finally take on the gym leader. Okay, I gotta give you an item, man. Life orb would be great. Black belt, actually we'll give you a black belt. I feel like giving him the life orb just for the sake of just giving him the life orb. I'm gonna give him the life orb. you know, we're gonna give him life orb. Because we're gonna need the extra power. The power! That's for sure. Anyway, let's make our way through. Are you ready? Let's take on this Dragon Master together! Yes! Let's go. He's a Dragon Master, yeah, he uses ice types. As well as flying, as well as the Dragon types. That's nuts. I think most of the gyms have like a combination of different typings. They just have one main theme. That's pretty much it. Hey, challengers, my acolytes told me you have completed the 5 trials. You have demonstrated great willpower to make it this far. Strength, wisdom, adaptability, faith, and willingness to seek the truth. These are all characteristics of a true-hearted trainer. Only those that are pure of heart and filled with determination can be worthy of the power of Mega Evolution. That's right. And now, me and Axion are going to battle you. I'm Baron, the Dragon, Arbiter of Mega Evolution and Tandor. You may have passed the trials, but one final test awaits you. Prove to me that you are worthy. Anyway, make sure you bring a Pokemon that is available. Make sure you bring a Pokemon that is that can Mega Evolve, like your starter. I think every starter in this game. Wow, Fia looks a bit different. Anyway, every starter in this game can Mega Evolve, so get him. There's no reason why you couldn't. Anyway, his first two Pokemon are Dunsarath, Dragon Flying type, level 52, Dragon Pulse, Skyfall, Coil, and Outrage as his attacks. Then you have Glavinog, level 52, Surf, Ice Beam, Protect, Recover as his attacks, Swift Swim as his ability, and his Water Ice type. We've run into both these Pokemon before, so you should know what to do by now. And of course, we have our mate Theo helping us out with the Splendifile. Oh wow, that didn't even kill it. Wow. Okay, let's see how this lost some of his HP due to the Hurricane. Ooh, thank God we didn't get hit by that. That's a Sky Drop. I'm gonna use it in Splendifile, that's fine. That's fine, that's perfectly good. And of course he gets paralyzed. Ice Beam, oh no! On the Splendifile, thank God! I thought he was gonna hit Colikid there. But anyway, that's Theo's first Pokemon down. Why did you bring a Flying type to a battle between freaking Ice types? He knows he has Ice types there, which doesn't sense. Anyway, he's bringing Nucleon. Ooh, interesting. Nucleon is the nuclear evolution of Eevee, so that's something, I guess. We're gonna hit the Glavinard. Kill it with the Mug Punch. All we need next is the Dunsarath. Frank, Nucleon. What's he gonna do? Nuclear Pokemon, I think I've explained this before. Nuclear Pokemon, why did he go for that? He went for conversion too. I don't know what that does. Whatever it does. Wasn't really good. And Garlicate is dead because Sky Drop is 4 times super effective. But anyway, Nucleon is kind of a glass cannon. It's super effective against everything, but everything is super effective against it. So yeah, that's the disadvantage of using such a Pokemon. But anyway, my next Pokemon, I believe, I think I'll go with Dermafrost here. That'll be great. And then on the next turn, we're gonna hit this thing with Avalanche. But anyway, his next Pokemon is Alpico, level 53, Ice Fairy type with the ability Competitive or Technician, with the attacks Ice Beam, Fake Out, Dazzling Gleam, and Blizzardo. So, probably got Fake Out in the first turn. Oh, is this one of the moves that one? Okay, we'll hit him. We'll hit the Dunsarath. Ice Beam. Super effective. Nucleon might die here. Maybe he'll live. Ooh, it lives. Just the lowest HP. Lazarus, mate, go for an actual move that works, for freak's sake. Mate, you are. He is easily the weakest link here. I do everything by myself. Come on, man. Avalanche. Okay, so he didn't go for Fake Out. He used to go for Fake Out first, which is interesting. I guess he didn't want to go for it this time. Hopefully, that Dunsarath won't die. Of course, he won't. Because it's just life, isn't it? Okay. Escatres. Oh, his that water and ground type Pokemon that I had problems with in that one gym. It's final evolution, so that's pretty cool. This Pokemon isn't very fast, but it has a very unique typing in ground and water, so it's only weak to grass type Pokemon, but four times weak to grass type Pokemon, so that's pretty cool. Anyway, went for... was that Blizzard? I think so. Blizzard always hits in the hail, so you might want to cross it. Oh, he fall out immediately. That's great. Muddy Water! Please don't kill me. I think Muddy Water hits both of the Pokemon on the opponent's side of the field. I think it should do that, but who knows. Anyway, what's the next Pokemon? Oh, it has the ability Competitive. I think competitive is like, if you get hit with a move that maybe lowers your stats, it will increase one of its other stats, I think that's how it works. But anyway, the next Pokemon is Andarind, level 53, Ice and Ground type with the ability Rivalry, with the attacks Acrobatics, Earthquake, Avalanche, and Bulk Up. We're going to hit this thing with a nice little Rock Slide, why not? Blizzard, of course, gonna do what that does, but not gonna do too much damage to us. I say that, it's not very effective, but did a lot of damage there. Escatres, just not living that, okay. Bulk up, I'm going for bulk up. Come on. Man, Leo's not really helping us here, is he? Rock slide. Is he not here, bro? So weird. No, it does hit both. But anyway, there goes the Alpico. Permafrost, you're gonna live very long, are you? Heroine is the next Pokemon. Why didn't you start with this Pokemon, you idiot? Why didn't you start with the fighting type? Whatever. Anyway, next Pokemon is a Fafninta with the typing of Ice and Dragon. Its ability, it is Ferco, is level 55 with the attacks Avalanche, Dragon Dance, Dragon Tail, and Rock Slide. Anyway, man, Leo made me so angry I almost forgot what I was going to say. That's how mad I was. Anyway, Dermafrost was kind of low health, so I'm going to use this turn to heal up. Of course, he goes for Dragon Dance, but why not? Like, you know, just boost your attacks like that. Hopefully, Acrobatics. Man, it's like these guys. He has all every single Pokemon he has is specifically geared to just fuck with Theo. Like, it's literally every other whatever. Anyway, we're gonna go for Rock Slide here. It's gonna be super effective on the Fafninta. We're gonna get hit with the Rock Slide as well. Super effective hit. We shouldn't die from this, I don't think. Yeah, it's a crit and it's super effective, but we don't die from it, so that's good. Earthquake. Oh no. Oh no. Shoot. I need it done, of course. Might still need him now. Miasmatic. Please live. Of course it doesn't. That's what they're there for. Okay, so... what was that? I don't know. Anyway, I'm guessing it was Miasmatic's ability. Next Pokemon. We're gonna go with Achilles here, possibly. Hopefully do some business here. Metalinx, I'm guessing that's his last Pokemon. Okay, so first off, we need to get rid of the Andarind 100%, because it does have Earthquake. And... okay, so I was just checking if Andarind was weak to fire type Pokemon. It is. So hopefully this kills. Oh yeah, all right. Everything's gone. So Metalinx is at least safe for now. Because it's not going to get hit with Iron Tail. Wow. This should kill it, I think. No. Okay. Man, this thing has really strong defense. It went for Dragon Tail. Oh, okay. So Dragon Dance would normally... What did it do? Gem's coming up. Okay. Anyway, Dragon Tail is a move that has low priority, so it would always go last. So that's not funny. But Ampharos is the next Pokemon. Oh dearie me. Oh dearie dearie me. Because guess what this thing is holding? Yes, you heard right, ladies and gentlemen. I haven't said it yet, but this thing is a it actually holds the Ampharosite. When it does that, it will gain the ability Mold Breaker and become an electric dragon type. Right now it's just pure electric, but it'll become an electric dragon type with the attacks Thunderbolt, Dragon Pulse, Agility, and Focus Blast. So yeah, this thing is not going to be good to have on the field right now. Jelen will probably die here. Behold the power of Mega Evolution. Mega Shinka! Mega Ampharos is here! I don't know whether or not... So, Mega Evolution maybe carries on the Gen 6 way of how Mega Evolution works. But basically, Mega Evolution, on the first turn, your speed stat is not changed. So, if you were meant to go second on the turn that you Mega... On the turn that you... No, if you were meant to go first on the turn that you Mega Evolved, and you, the Mega Evolved Pokemon had, I believe, lower... Oh, thing. Oh, shit, Metalinx is dead. Yeah, Metalinx is so dead. 100%. Anyway, on the turn that... Ampharos Mega Evolved, its speed stat would remain the same, so if it was supposed to go first on the turn that Mega Evolved... Like, if it was normally, Mega Ampharos, if it was faster than your Pokemon, it would be out of speed, it would go first. But, if the opponent, Okay, so, my opponent has Mega Ampharos, right? On the first turn, let's say I have a Garchomp with 100 base speed, right? And then Mega Ampharos Mega Evolved. Its base speed would increase, so it would technically be faster than my Garchomp. But because of Gen 6, it would actually be slower because speed stats don't get transferred until the next turn. They changed that in Generation 7, which is good because now a lot more Pokemon can... Like, it saves up a speed, it saves up a slot for like Pokemon like Mega Beedrill, so they don't need to use Protect anymore. So they can use some other moves. We're gonna take out the Fafnir, possibly, if I can. Of course, it's not very effective. That was a horrible idea. Why did I go for Mega Drain? Why did I go for. Whatever, made that mistake. Dragon Pulsar. Okay, Avalanche. What kind of kills? Man, for a Pokemon that has, Ice Dragon. Ice Dragon. S51A would be the perfect Pokemon for this situation. Thing is, you don't have any Steel-type moves that worth a damn! Like Gyro Ball. Gyro Ball sucks. Gyro Ball actually sucks. It's awful. Don't ever use it. But you do have Asian power, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna switch you in, because that's all I can do. Hopefully we'll be able to kill the Fafninta with Run for Rock Song. Not very effective. Asian power. Maybe we get the boost. It would be great if we got the boost. Come on, give me the boost. Nope, no boost. Basically, Ancient Power, I believe, has like 5% chance of giving you, of raising every single stat. So that would be special attack, special defense. It'd be special attack, it'd be attack, defense, special attack, special defense, and speed. So there's an advantage to that. So I'm gonna go for Ancient Power again. Hopefully we can. Probably won't kill because Electric Dragon not weak to anything. That's fine. It doesn't matter. Because I think I do have my main man. Yeah, Achilles around. So if anything, we have a bit of an advantage here. Hopefully, magnitude is pretty high. Please, I asked for high magnitude, not a low magnitude, for freak's sake. Now we're probably going to dodge in whatever the next hit is. Man, Mega Ampharos is not very fast. Okay, Focus. The one time I wanted not to hit Focus Blast, it hits it, and now we're dead. Okay, so we have one last Pokemon left, and that is our main man, Bulbarog. What I'm gonna do is actually use. If I have a max repel, then. Not max repel, what am I saying? If I have a max revive, then I should be good. I don't think I do. Oh, it doesn't matter. Anyway, we'll just use just a normal revive. And we'll bring back Achilles. I don't expect to live the Thunderbolt he's about to hit me with. Yeah. But. Maybe Bulbarog's, because it has such high special defense, it lives. Nope, super effective. Okay, this is. Now, the ultimate luck. It's completely down to luck. I need to hit him with a hard enough magnitude. That's my only hope. Because otherwise. This is what could happen, right? I could hit the magnitude, it's a low number, it doesn't kill it. Or, and then I get hit with a focus blast and I lose this match. Or, I get a higher magnitude, kill it, and then I win. Or, I could use magnitude, get a low number, won't kill it, and then it misses focus blast. So, hopefully, I have a good enough chance here. Magnitude 5, twice in a row. You can't read this, man. You couldn't. Whatever. Which one am I gonna get? Oh, it's Dragon Pulse. I thought he was gonna go for Focus Blast again. No, Dragon Pulse. Please don't kill me. Oh, for freak's sake! You gotta be kidding me. That's how much. Cut! finally freaking did it. Oh my god. Oh my god. That was something. That was something else, that's for sure, ladies and gentlemen. Then we get the TM95 caustic breath. Oh man. Powerful dragon type attack that strips away your opponent's defenders. Now then. Can we get Mega Illusion, please? I want to get done. I'm hungry. I want to eat some food. Please. That was long. I've been sitting here for an hour. Oh my god. That's crazy. Anyway, we get the Metal Lynx Eye. No, Fio gets Metal Lynx Eye. And, you're wondering if it, why is it going so fast? It's because I'm using something that speeds this game up. I want Aquiles to be able to Mega Evolve, so Aquiles Eye will be given to me. And we get that in our old item party. So, yeah. Now Aquiles can Mega Evolve. That's cool. Mate! please, I don't want to do this anymore. Well, okay, so I fixed it now, so now it won't be as fast anymore. Okay, so for some reason now he wants to Mega Evolve. Okay, we have to press the Z button and then Flamethrower. Aquiles will Mega Evolve into Mega Aquiles. Ooh, this is nice. I wonder what Metalink looks like when it Mega Evolves. Aquiles, badass. Wow, looks pretty cool. I like this version of Aquiles. Metalink looks cool as well, but it'll die in one hit. That's just how it is. Bye bye. Okay, that was relatively easy. Oh! Does he have more Pokemon? Escatress. Is that? Okay. So, Jenin, come on out. Do business. Okay, so this is. I'm guessing this is a full battle. As soon as. Why? Come on, man. Just give me a break. Give me a break, goddammit. Giga Drain. Come on, one hit, please. I want this as done as quickly as possible. And yeah, this. It goes down so slowly. Just if it's a one hit KO, it should just wipe away like boom. No need to make people energy ball. Energy ball sucks. Yeah, I don't want energy ball. Okay, next Pokemon, Splendifowl. Dumfrost should do it. Okay, Splendifowl, level 50, flying normal, you don't like a avalanche, will you? Ooh, flash cannon, got lunch, but steel type moves, we should live, I think. It's not stat, yeah, we okay. Okay, one hit KO, easy. Easy piece. This is easy. Come on. What else you got? Hero Loon, ground and fighting? So that means that like a water type move to the face. So Blubber Up should do well here. Okay, level 52. Surf. Oh yeah, we learned Sludge Wave. So I got rid of Sludge. I don't know much better, Sludge Wave or Sludge Bomb. I think Sludge Bomb is physical and Sludge Wave is special. So, I guess Grubarole will benefit more from Sludge Wave because it's more of a special attacker than it is a physical attacker. Miasmatic is Psychic and Fairy, I believe. So, yeah, we'll stay in. Or Dark and Fairy. Or maybe it's Ghost and Fairy, I don't know, but either way, it doesn't like a Sludge Wave to the face. Okay, so is it Psychic? It's Psychic and maybe it's Psychic and Fairy, I don't know. Maybe I'm confusing myself, but yeah, Miasmatic Okay. Sludge Wave. Sludge Wave has the same animation for Surf, just purple. Has that weird sound effect side to it. Silver effective, but won't kill me. Because that's Blue Rock's gigantic special defense coming into play here. Okay, one more should do it. Thank God it doesn't have any healing items. Otherwise, that would be unbearable. Okay, next Pokemon, please! Nucleon! This thing is weak to anything. So, S54, S51A, you'll come out and you'll do the business. S51A can Mega Evolve in this game as well, so that's interesting. Zen Headbutt. Okay, and kill, but it failed. Oh no, Miracle failed. Miracle only works for moves that are special based, not moves that are physical based. Remember how it works. Zen Headbutt. Okay, I'm sorry if I sound bored. I honestly have been sitting here for 1 hour recording this game, and I'm super hungry. I want to go eat. Well, it looks like I lost again. Haha, something's never changed, even with the power of Mega Evolution. Of course, you had Mega on your side too, so I'm not surprised. Well fought, both of you. I haven't seen a battle that climatic in years. It's clear the two of you have each made an incredible journey. Now the power of Mega Evolution is yours to keep. Use it wisely. Remember what you learned in your trials. I will. Good. I think you two the best. I wish you two the best luck of your travels. All right. I feel it. I think we should tell the prof about how we both got Mega Evolution. I'll call him in the pub right now. No, I wanna end the pod. Please, this pod has been ridiculously long. Please, just let me end the pod. Okay, upgrade your Pokédex. Looks like you're still in Snorlax. I'll fly over there. Okay, so we'll come Snorlax Town. That's great. We'll talk to you soon. Okay. Okay. So that is it, ladies and gentlemen. All we gotta do is walk to the Pokemon Center, and that'll be the end of today's part. Man, what a long part. We battled our trainer, we did the 5 trials, we defeated the gym leader twice. Okay, oh my god, the first time. Oh my god. Oh, we defeated the gym leader, we had to go through him twice. But in the next part, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna continue on with this game and see and make our way to the 7th, to the last gym. In the 8th and final gym, because I believe this was the 7th gym, so the next gym will be the 8th gym. So thank you guys for watching, hope you guys enjoyed, leave a like if you did, and of course subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys later for some more Pokemon Uranium. Peace!